try not to stay much on pump. Try to, if you can do it on pump, it's great. If you're not, there is no shame in going on pump and try to do the best job you can. I tell people, and again, I'm sorry I have to rush a little bit to this, but bottom line is this: why do we make big holes in the chest? Because look at me, I got big hands, okay? I got to get my hands in the chest. If I have a different, if I can do the operation the same way without getting my big hands in the chest, then chances are the incision will be small. And that brings us to a different point. What's minimal invasive surgery? I would talk about the off pump surgery. I would then stay off of being on pump. Are we talking about basically small incisions? Well, the truth is somewhere in between, okay? Adequate exposure. It's very important to be able to see. I was talking to some of my colleagues. I've done a urinary valve through a small right thoracotomy just before I came here. Patient did very well. It took me probably 5.5 hours to just totally unreasonable for a urinary valve just because I couldn't see much. Routinely should take 2 hours skin to skin. So obviously you have to be able to see about what you're doing. 3D vision, that's important. We have all sorts of tools, and again, I'm not going to spend much time, but basically on our screens, even though high definitions, there are 2Ds. And even though we're used to operate on 2Ds, when you teach residents and fellows, the depth perception is very, very important. Technology must be able to help us. We don't want to spend $1 million and not get too far. Obviously, the cost is important. You got to be honest about things you do and things you don't. Like, if it takes too long, just go ahead and enlarge the incision and do it the right way. Yeah. Obviously, you have to be comfortable with what you're doing. How did we start? Well, first of all, let's think about the sternotomy. Okay, what do you do? First of all, try to do a mini sternotomy. The same sternotomy, just make a smaller incision, cut a little bit less of the skin, try to torture yourself a little bit, and to raising the skin above and below, and use your loops to watch, actually, to direct the operation. Level two, you go to a smaller incision video assist. You put a video camera, usually a 5mm video camera. Not only that allows you to see better, but what allows you is to get a better illumination, better lighting within your surgical field. Micro port incisions, now the incisions get much, much smaller. And what you're doing, not only, the key here is not video assisted, it's video directed. So what you should do, especially on a micro valve repair, you should be able to do the operation looking at the screen. And level four, using robotic instruments. Now, this is pretty much the older picture. Now we have high definition screens, but bottom line, what you can see, the head of the patient, chest, belly, and so on. This is the right chest, the Romanian thoracotomy. We got smaller retractors, actually we use some soft tissue retractors made by Aztec. And what you see some pericardial sutures placed right up through the skin. And what you do, you tighten those once you go on pump. Go on pump in the groin, you can generate the groin. You have actually a cross clamp, it's a chido cross clamp, which comes percutaneous, so you can have a flappy cross clamp up here. The operation is being done by surgeon either looking through the incision, which is a 3D vision, or obviously looking at the screen. And this is a little bit of a larger view. Here we used to have a robotic arm, voice activated. It did not work very well. I have a Romanian accent when I speak English, or some sort of an accent. Then to tell you, they got trouble understanding my accent. So it's a little bit of a pain. We kind of gave it up. This is a little bit of a newer picture. You still have a mini thoracotomy. We still put a decent sized retractor in. For some of you that do thoracic surgery, the key here is to just open the parietal pleura. Put your headlight and open the parietal pleura toward the sternum and toward the spine. That would enable you to open the retractor a bit more. And naturally, it's a soft tissue retractor, again, made by Cardiovascular Aesthetic, and allows you to keep the soft tissue out of the way. What you have, you have a 5mm port right in here, and which, again, enables you to see better what you're doing. And here you see a percutaneous retractor placed in. There are issues. Now, you still need a decent size thoracotomy. Not that bad, okay? 3D vision only works.